so our timer, we have a timer ready?
Yep.
Video person ready?
I'm just gonna count to three and then I'll let you.
That's already recording.
Okay. According to PewResearch.org, there are 20.4 million veterans in the United States. That only makes up about 10% of our population, but I imagine at least everyone in this room can think of at least one veteran that they know. My name is Kelly Robinson, Applied Communication student at the University of Arkansas at Little Rock, and today I'm going to tell you about my service learning. First, I'm going to tell you exactly what I did and where I did it at. Second, I'm going to apply a communication principle and two communication concepts to said service learning. And lastly, I'm going to tell you how I can improve my own communication. So let me tell you where I did my project at. I completed my hours at the Eugene Tobin Veteran Affairs Hospital in North Little Rock. During my time there, I noticed that there were a bunch of veterans that needed our help. And as previously mentioned, there are 20.4 million veterans in the United States. The National Coalition for Homeless Veterans states that the number of homeless veterans is increasing, so the VA has put programs in place to help combat this. My organization has one key idea, which is put together beautifully by a quote from Abraham Lincoln: to care for him who shall have borne the battle, and for his widow and his orphan. I worked with various amounts of people at the VA, but the main one was a guy named Ron. Ron was an interesting fellow. He and I worked the donation room, and when he showed me the donation room, he showed me a literal mess of a room. There was little to no organization, so if you wanted to find something, you really had to search for it. So, seeing as I had no official task, I made it my personal mission to organize that room, or I was going to suffer trying. During my time at the VA, I also went out of my way to be extremely nice and lovely to everyone who came in. Because after I got it somewhat organized, the veterans would come in and get closer and freely around the VA. But the room was a sad, drag place. I kind of attributed this to the workers in the room not really helping anybody and Ron being completely frustrated with the state of the room. So by me organizing it and me being extremely bubbly and nice to anybody who came in, it shows how I clearly honored the mission of the VA. Moving on. There's a communication principle and two communication concepts directly related to my service learning. Why should anybody care? Everybody communicates with these principles and these concepts, but they may not actually realize it, so it's a good idea to take notice when you can. The communication principle relevant to my service learning is communication involves both verbal and nonverbal messages. The definition, according to the UN Survival Guide of 2018, is all behavior has symbolic potential. This includes the words that we speak, as well as our vocal and nonverbal communication. An example from my service learning would be a woman who came in with her social worker while I was organizing Hallmark cards. She decided to tell me every little detail of every little thing she did and every little place that she was discharged to. However, when it seemed that those when she was talking, she was expected to be told to be quiet. Instead, I just nodded my head and casually organized the Hallmark cards as any volunteer would do. I remember her specifically mentioning that she wanted a Rubik's Cube. We didn't have one, but I told her about fidget spinners. She had never heard of them before, and so I explained to her what they did for kids with anxiety and autism, and she made it her mission that day to go out and get one. I left the VA that day feeling a little bit better about my time there. And my example illustrates this point, because if I had shown how annoyed I was, the fact that I was organizing Hallmark cards, or the fact that she was bothering me with every minute detail, she would have felt offended or even annoyed that I would treat her such a way. And she probably would never come back to the VA even though she needed to. So a simple smile meant not only the world to her, but to myself as well. The first communication concept directly related to my service learning would be culture. According to Alder, Rodman, and Dupree of 2017, the definition of culture is the language, traditions, beliefs, and customs people share and learn. My example for my service would be the entire feeling of the VA, especially if you're an outsider to military culture like I was. When you're an outsider to military culture, it's really interesting to watch the intergroup communication between the vets and non-vets, especially how they would communicate with me. It seemed as though the vets would have to kind of watch themselves to make sure that they didn't use any military jargon, because if they had, who would have been completely lost on me? However, they appreciated my time being there even though I was just in the donation room and immediately accepted me. The second communication principle would be mindful listening. The textbook defines this as being fully present with people, taking notice of their gestures, mannerisms, and silences, as well as to the words that they say. An example from my service would be a man who came in looking for a list of things. Every item on the list was misspelled. Shoes was S-H-O-S-E, pants were P-A-N-C-E, etc. example illustrates this point because he was completely embarrassed by the state of the list. And he kept apologizing for every little item. Instead of berating him, I simply looked at the list, gathered what I needed, and asked him very seldom questions about it, only to clarify its sizes. Because I was mindful of his behavior, he started to eventually warm up to us and start chatting about random things. And so he left that day with things on that he didn't actually list but needed, like toothbrush and deodorant, things that you would think of, but he didn't. If I hadn't been mindful of his behavior, he probably would have been too embarrassed and would have left with things that he didn't actually need or things that he couldn't actually use, and then never would have came back because he was too embarrassed by the state of the list. So he left that day with things that he actually needed, and I left that day feeling a little bit better as well. Based on my surface experience, I can improve my communication with communication concepts as well as ethical implications. Hopefully, once I implement these into my own communication, I can spark the drive in others to go out and do the same as I did and help their community. And a communication concept that I would use to improve my own communication would be prompting. The textbook defines this as using silences and brief statements of encouragement to draw out a speaker. I chose this concept because I am not necessarily comfortable with the idea of silence in a conversation or even around strangers. During my first few hours at the VA, it was extremely quiet and I was completely uncomfortable. I kind of thought it was because I was there, but then I soon realized it was 7 in the morning and nobody wants to talk before their first cup of coffee. So, once I implement this into my own communication, I can take pressure off of myself to initiate conversation where it's not really needed, and thus making it way easier on me and my anxiety. An ethical implication I can use to improve my community would be concern for community. I chose this implication because it seems like no matter where I go, if there's an opportunity to volunteer, hardly anybody jumps at the chance to do so. This can leave a community feeling hopeless. So, hopefully, after I start voicing my own concerns for my community and showing people why they should care, and what they can do with the least amount of effort, they can go out and start voicing their own concerns, and thus causing a chain reaction and improving the community little by little. So in conclusion, today I told you about my service learning project. I told you about what I did and where I did that. I applied a communication principle as well as 2 communication concepts to said service learning, and I told you how I can improve my own communication. Remember, there are 20.4 million veterans in the United States. Just as they protected our freedoms, we need to help them.